Hello everyone, how are you? Welcome back to English class. So in the previous class we were discussing about an elephant who was just 5 months old called Curry. I hope that is clear for you. So let us continue the second part of the story. Are you ready? Okay, now take your textbook, page number 10. Page number 10. Shall we start? Okay. Curry was like a baby. He had to be trained to be good, and if you did not tell him when he was naughty, he was up to more mischief than ever. Underline the word mischief. Mischief means playful behavior. Mischief. M-I-S. M-I-S. Mischief. Mischief means playful behavior. So playful behavior of Curry is called as mischief. So Curry is like a baby, naughty baby. He had to be trained to be good, and if you did not tell him when he was naughty, he was up to more. That means Curry, as we told that Curry is a naughty one, but we have to say Curry that at a particular time we should inform him that you are naughty, don't do that much. Otherwise, he will be more mischief. That means he will be more playful and naughty. For instance, one day somebody gave him some bananas to eat. Very soon, he developed a great love for ripe bananas. Ripe bananas, what is that? Bananas, as you all seen here, you can see the picture of ripe bananas. We use it to keep large plates of fruits on a table near a window in the dining room. One day all the bananas on that table disappeared, and my family blamed the servants for eating all the fruit in the house. So in that boy's home, they used to kept a basket full of fruits on their dining table, and there were many ripe bananas there. One day all these bananas were disappeared, and his parents scolded all the servants. They thought that the servants all steal that bananas. But who was it really? Yeah, servants for eating all the fruits in the house. A few days later, the fruit disappeared again. This time, the blame was put on me, and I knew I had not done it. It made me very angry with my parents and the servants, for I was sure they had taken all the fruits. The next time, the fruit disappeared. So, next time also the ripe bananas were disappeared. All of them were disappeared. Then first time his family cursed the servants. Then second time his family cursed him, the boy. And the boy got very angry because he know that he don't took any bananas from that basket. Then he was in search of that thief who was stealing all those ripe bananas from the dining table. The next time the fruit disappeared, I found a banana all smashed up in Curry's pavilion. This surprised me very much, for I had never seen fruit there as. And as you know, he had always lived on tea. So, one day, the boy saw some ripe bananas on Curry's pavilion. Then the boy got very much surprised. How could these bananas came here in Curry's pavilion? He got surprised by seeing the bananas on his pavilion, and he thought that the boy was really surprised by seeing that bananas, and he had always lived on twigs. And the boy also thought that Curry don't eat that kind of fruits or anything, he just have only twigs, branches, etc. Next day, while I was sitting in the dining room wondering whether I should take some fruit from the table, without my parents' permission, a long black thing very much like a snake suddenly came through the window and disappeared with all the bananas. I was very much frightened because I had never seen snakes eat bananas, and I thought it must be a terrible snake that would sneak in and take fruit. Then one day, this boy was sitting on the dining table. He was about to eat some fruits. Then suddenly he saw something. Here comes a snake-like thing from that window and took the ripe bananas from the basket. Then by seeing that, the boy got very much frightened. He thought that this must be a special or a terrible snake who used to eat bananas or fruits. Then the boy got very much frightened, feared. I crept out of the room and with great fear in my heart ran out of the house. Underline the word crept. Crept. C-R-E-P-T. Crept. C-R-E-P-T. Crept means take. Crept means take. And the I take out of the room and with great fear in my heart ran out of the house, feeling sure that the snake would come back into the house, eat all the fruits and kill all of us. Then by seeing that snake-like thing, the boy got frightened, feared, and he followed that thing. And the boy thought that a snake will come again and it took all other fruits and also kill all of us. All of us who were living in that house. The boy was really feared by seeing that snake-like thing. As I went out, I saw Kari's back disappearing in the direction of the pavilion. And I was so frightened that I wanted his company to cheer me up. I ran after him into the pavilion and I found him there eating bananas. I stood still in astonishment. Underline the word astonishment. Astonishment means surprised. Surprised. Okay. Then the boy gone to that near that window. Then he saw Kari was disappearing from that place. I ran after him into the pavilion and found him there eating bananas. I stood in astonishment. Then the boy followed Kari. Then the boy reached the pavilion of the Kari. Then he saw that the Kari was eating those bananas. Then by seeing that, the boy got astonished. Astonished means surprised. That by seeing that the Kari was eating those bananas, the boy got really surprised. The bananas were lying strewn, S-T-R-E-W. S-T-R-E-W, strewn, that means scattered. Scattered. Okay, then the boy saw all the bananas were scattered on Kari's pavilion. Then around him, he stretched out his trunk and reached for one far away from where he was standing. That instant, so who was taking all those bananas? Yes, it's Kari who looted all the bananas from the dining table. It's not a terrifying snake or it's not servants or that boy who looted all those bananas. It's Kari who looted all the bananas from the dining table. Trunk looked like a black snake and I realized that was a Kari thief. I went to him, pulled him out by the ear and joyously shouted my parents that it was Kari and not I that had eaten all the fruit these many weeks. Then, actually at the end, the boy came to know that it was Kari. It's not a terrifying snake and the trunk of the Kari that really looks like a terrifying snake. Then the boy called out his parents and told them that it's not a snake or it's not the servants of me. It's the thief was Kari who looted all the ripe bananas from our dining table. Then I scolded him. The four elephants understood words as well as children. And I said to him, next time I see you stealing fruit, you will be whipped. Underline the word whipped. Whipped. Whipped means beaten. And the boy taught Kari that next time, this is okay. Then next time, if you continue this process, continue looting these bananas from the dining table, you will be definitely whipped. Whipped means beaten. You will get beat from me. You will definitely punished for looting all these fruits from the dining table. Then actually this boy was saying that animals can understand what we are saying. They can understand what we are saying, what we are conveying to them. He knew that we were all angry with him, even the servants. His pride was so injured that he never stole another thing from the dining room. And from then on, if nobody gave him any fruit, he always skewled as it to thank them. Skewled, in the previous class I told that skewled means a kind of sound produced by elephants is called as skewled. Got it, okay. Actually, Kari felt really shame because all of them, that is that boy, his parents and servants, all of them came to know that he was a real thief. Then he was really like a shame. Then at that time itself, He stopped eating those fruits. Then, whenever anyone offered him any fruits or bananas, he make a squealing sound. He produce a kind of sound, but he won't accept that offer. He don't buy that fruits from any people. An elephant is willing to be punished for having done wrong. But if you punish him without any reason, he will remember it and pay you back in your own coin. So here, this sentence is very important. That is, if that elephant done any wrong things, we can definitely punish that elephant. But without doing any wrong things, if we punish that elephant, they will definitely pay us. So we should remember while hurting the elephants. So that is, elephant is a very good animal, very friendly. I know all of you, most of you have seen this elephant, right? Yes, it's common. We can see in our nearly festivals, temple festivals, we can see elephants commonly. And don't hurt elephants without any reason. Don't punish them. If we do so, they will remind that at a long period of time, and they will definitely surely pay for that. So this is the second part of the story. All of you read your textbook. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the DCS. So that's all. Thank you.